Skunkbird is a little wide open out there.
So in the flats?
Right. And Pond Set, all those trees are just blocked everything. So, I mean, I would like to. I still haven't made a final decision there.
So. But you might find a real lizard man in Skunkbird.
I heard a little story about it. That's supposed to be a sighting. With the eclipse that's supposed to be happening or something like that.
Yeah.
So,
on Monday.
Yeah. That's not gonna play. But any
that's Parkberry is a good fishing home, but
yes, yes. Jimmy, as a matter of fact, me and him gonna go out next month. So we're gonna do this again, probably the 16th of next month. Write for things, all this, you know, talk to everyone, tell you what to expect. Make sure I get good contact information. I'm going to email some things to you.
Hi.
If I could just
go
get you guys
signed
in, email, and contact number. And so when we come back next month, we're, you know, going to get all the paperwork out of the way. So when, you know, when we actually start filming 2 weeks later, ain't got to worry about, you know, paperwork. You guys don't have to stay the whole time at once. I've asked your question and talked to you one-on-one and got all the information you need. You're free to go, and you know, we'll get together again.
Started about 5 years ago. I did an internship for Warner Brothers under Andre Tippin, and I decided to branch out and, you know, started my own after not getting paid and, you know, getting all the knowledge, but it was good because what I learned from there helped me a lot more. We all family, so you know, get the fright out. But if you'd rather have a one-on-one and not answer any questions, you know, I respect that, and I'll address that one-on-one after the meeting.
So July 8th, we discussed that we were having another meeting, this actual meeting here. We talked about the movie a little bit. We talked about the incentive plan. The incentive plan, is basically which will allow anyone associated that contributed to this film the opportunity to make up to $4,500 or $4,600 based on how well the film does in the movie theater. We have a portal at kbproduction.com. You'll be able to go there and check the status every day on that. What will happen is at the end of the month, whatever the theater sales was for the Creature Escape Quarry, it would give you a clicker and it let you know, okay, hey, we met the goal for the first tier, second tier, the third tier. You're going to get all three tiers if you hit. So it's not like most incentive plans where once you get one, you know, then you just get the higher the two. You're getting all three, okay? And to qualify for that, you either have to be in the movie or you had to contribute to the movie in any way, you know, financially or being extra, which most of you guys in here now are either going to contribute being in the film, so get to save your money in your pockets. The next meeting that we're going to have, probably going to be the same location I'm comfortable with. Getting here, the facility, so we'll probably meet here again, probably the 16th of September. If you can't make it, that's fine. The reason I had you to fill out that form in the back with your contact number, just in case my email kick you back and go check your emails on a regular basis, I can, you know, just call you up and say, okay, hey, you know, I would like to, you know, talk to you about a particular job, particular role, or something, something like that. Instead of Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, it's probably going to be a Friday, Saturday. That way, it will allow most of you guys to have full-time job to, yeah, instead of trying to take time off, you can able to still work and then come in on Friday. So what will happen on Friday when you get there, we'll have a little rehearsal and we'll go over some things, camera movement, rehearse lines for those that have lines, position and stuff like that, which is still a paid day, okay? So, and then Saturday, we'll just film all day. Filming times will change because I don't know what the weather's gonna be. I know it's hurricane season coming up, or are we in hurricane season now? So if there's no weather issues or anything, you know, we will skip to that schedule. And we would keep that schedule. But if anything changes, then of course, we're still gonna stay with the Friday, Saturday. I don't see a Sunday coming into a play and throughout the week. I really don't see that. And for Monday through Fridays, it's normally it will be after working hours. So it would normally probably be an indoor facility where we can actually go over the green screen, go over movement, stuff like that. Normally, any filming that's going to take place in a wooded area, we will have that during the daytime so we can do visual of critters and bugs and everything like that. So breaking down the script, there's only maybe about 10 hours of filming in the woods anyway. So everything else is about the green screen. Anyone know what the green screen is? Okay. All right. For those that don't know, green screen just makes my job a lot easier. You know, we can, you know, we get used to seeing that it's actually the green screen.
That's where you use it for the computer.
You use the computer, you know, like Superman fly and, you know, stuff like that. It's done on the green screen, so. Okay. We're gonna have a gala after filming. It's scheduled for October 14th right now. And you can purchase your tickets at kbproductions.com if you want. So you get a chance to get dressed up and good food, good music. You know, talk. We can talk more about the theater releasing for the film that we just finished filming, and new opportunities for more film projects in 2018. So if you can make the gala, if it's within your budget, I think it's $50 for per person, or $80 if you bring, you know, a friend or significant other. And yes, I have to pay for my own stuff too. So it won't be no freebie for me.
Excuse me, Reggie, where is the gala going to be held?
Well, That will depend on the amount of people that can attend. Ponset, one of their Hope Centers that we looked at that can fit 300 to 400 people, and also the Civic Center. I'm talking with them. So if we say that we get like 100 people, then the Hope Center work. But if we get 300 or 400 people, then I'm looking at utilizing the Civic. Utilize the Civic Center.
Okay, thank you.
So it really, really depends. I have two options, but it really depends on, you know, how many people are able to make it. From time to time, it's because you want to put enough information out there, but you don't want to put too much out there, you know, because then, you know, people are like, okay, I've already seen this before, I'm bored with it. So that's probably why you've seen several. But for me, there should only be two. Yeah, there was all green. That's actually how the creature would look on set.
band t-shirt. With that, so this is actually how he's gonna look. So it's a full copy. So head, tail, little skin. So I will actually have a guy. That's out in Bishopville. That's actually where actually originated from. That's how it look. There, the actor that will be doing that will be here a couple of days to do that for us. Seems that he really needs. But if I could get someone else into the suit to play it, but I'm gonna use mocap suit, so gray suit make it easy. Because sometimes in South Carolina it's hot.
Really?
I don't want nobody passing out. You know. Sometimes.
It's not the heat; it's the humidity.
Yeah. Now, what will happen is a portion of this we're going to shoot early in Los Angeles, so we're probably going to start doing that. I would like to start, right at Labor Day. So some of it we're gonna already start shooting already before I get to you guys, and that's because I'm partnering with AMC on this, and I don't get to call all the shots.
Partner to have, though.
Yes.
That's a pretty good partner.
Yeah. So, a lot of lines. I'm going to let you guys be in your natural environment where, what comes naturally.
Cards? Oh, come on.
Get you away from cue cards.
One of the things
when somebody, that... When someone see you out there, they go like, hey, I want that guy. I want Michael.
Well, one of the things that you mentioned to me on the phone that I thought would be kind of cool to share with these guys, if you haven't already, and that is, how do you want people to feel after they watch this movie? Remember I mentioned to you, is it another swamp thing, kind of thing? Or something that you said to me that was like really, if you remember, it was really cool. But what kind of impact do you want to deliver with this film, which will really help people a lot in reference to how they're going to do their characters?
I want you to be scared. That's the hard thing. I'm a big fan of the cryptic movies and things like that. And so I saw opportunity with this to turn this into, Bigfoot. Bigfoot-like. When Bigfoot, came out and, everyone tried to make movies about it, they were like, hey, this is not going to work. And up today, I just read on the plane where they had a sighting in North Carolina, Bigfoot, a couple weeks ago. How true it is, I don't know. But I'll take that, too. But the storyline is real, real good. This will be considered a short, and so you guys will understand the reason why we're going to short, because you have to build a fan base first. You don't want to pour a lot of money into a film if you don't have a fan base. So if you do it as a short, it'll come to the movie theaters as a 40-minute feature. And if it does well, which after a million, there's another 20 minutes that they're gonna add to it, 25 to be exact. And then AMC gonna re-release it. That's a good thing too, but that's a little some extra inside information. Anyone else?
Yeah, I've got a quick question. Are you going to build any of the characters, like, depending upon, who is actually in front of the camera here, are you going to build their character, so to speak, as well to kind of get people an idea that when this person is out here doing this, kind of the walk of life or, like, where they came from or the kind of person that they are, so that the audience, so to speak, can kind of really identify more with them as a person? Understand kind of what I'm saying.
Right, I understand what you're saying. Normally, that happens for main characters.
like normally, you know, most roles here, you know, maybe a tourist, maybe a teacher, maybe a store clerk, or someone like that. So it's not a main role. So if it's not a main role, you don't have to build.
Oh, so do you already have your main role characters?
Yes, that's
picked?
That's what we're filming in LA. So this is more of supporting. You know,
okay.
So
you can't be the star. We're sorry.
Yeah, but you know you still look good. I mean, still get some exposure. So you know that's the what happens a lot is people watch movies, whether it's in movie theaters or online, and they see people, then they'll call me up and say, hey, that Michael Cox, I saw IBMD,
Cox. Go home and let the dog out.
Hold your breath.
Yeah, right.
How do we get a hold of them? So, in Los Angeles, the hard part is getting in. I don't know how many you guys ever try acting or anything before. The hard part is just getting in. But once you get in, then, people, they're always going, always looking for you. So I'm going to do my part. Every speaking part, even if it's just one line and you just say hi, I'm gonna give everyone IBM IMDb credit. So good question. Any other question? So everything starts here, it never ends. You got a friend for life. We all won't be happy all the time. We all do things, but hey, you got a friend for life. So if anything I can do for you, make a phone call or show up at an event or something like that, just let me know. As you can see from meeting me and talking to me, I'm down to earth. I believe that if you take care of your people, everything else will fall in place.
So last time that we're all family, just different last names.
Different
so
last name?
That's like my favorite saying now.
Yeah.
So does that mean you'll take care of the speeding ticket like I did earlier too?
I don't. You really didn't get the speeding ticket?
No.
Okay.
you really wanted to be here.
I'm like, wow, I knew it was, I knew it was important, but hey. Wow, appreciate that though. Oh, that's good. So for those, if no more questions, one-on-ones, if a lot of people, whoever want to do some one-on-ones with me, we can do that. I want to make sure I can read everything on the list before. Tell me which cake, it could be more than one, which fits you, which is better, and then I'll respond from there. And then when we come back on the 16th, we'll have that already ironed out. So, but I'm going to give you guys some freedom to just be yourself. I want to see what you can. I want to see what you can do. And you still have to stick with it, but I'm not so focused on stick with it. I want to get the best out of you. And sometimes you just have to let a person be themselves, and then you just guide them.